Hello everyone, hi, and how are you all doing? So if you're new here, let me take a moment to introduce myself. I am Ridhila Bhaskar, an actor turned makeup artist, and today we're going to start off a new series of videos. We're going to talk all about makeup brushes. Many of you ask me on Instagram, what are the brushes I should buy? What is the kit of brushes that I should take? What is the best makeup brush kit that I can buy for professional makeup or personal makeup? Whatever it is, if you are interested in makeup, it's always better to avoid buying complete kits. As a makeup artist, I like to buy single brushes where I'll be investing lesser so I can get a lot of leverage to experiment on the different brushes I like. I think I would own like anywhere between 2000 to 3000 brushes in my makeup kit. I've never had the time to actually sit and count how many brushes and sets I own. But out of experience, I know that buying a kit is way more expensive, and a lot of brushes that you will not be using will be part of the kit. Than doing that, just getting a single brush is a lot better. You'll be saving a lot of money. At the same time, you will get the best from that particular brand. So I have designed this particular series in a way that I'm going to pick out the best brushes from my kit of about 2,000-2,500 brushes that I own. I'm going to pick out the best brushes that I own, and I'm going to show you. And it's not going to be just very expensive brushes. It's going to be brushes which are very drugstore as well. But you'll be able to see what are the different kinds of brushes, what are the different finishes it gives, and why I like these brushes. So today we're going to speak about foundation brushes. So before we jump into the video, don't forget to hit the subscribe button and hit the notification bell so that you'll be notified whenever I post a video. Now let's talk foundation brushes. So here I have a set of 5 foundation brushes, and I'm going to explain about each and every brush and the finish that each and every brush can give you. So first on the list is going to be the PAC 072 brush, okay? Just take a closer look of this brush. I know it's a little bit dirty, but nevertheless, it's a good brush. So this brush is very densely packed, okay? Until I move it, put pressure on these bristles, it's not going to move much. And this pressure is with my fingers. So when I sort of put this brush on my hand and start blending it, you can see it sort of packs on the product very well. So this brush is particularly very good when you want to blend foundation and get a full coverage. So I'm just putting a little bit of concealer on my hand. I'm going to use the PAC Take Cover Concealer over here, and I'm just going to use this brush to blend out the concealer. Okay, so this brush really will not move too much, and it will give you very full good coverage of the particular concealer or the foundation that you're using. And it's very important that this particular brush is very small, okay? So it's easy to fit under your eyes as well. So it's not tough to use this brush at all, even if it's a foundation or a concealer. This is a very good brush to use. So I'm going to give you a closer look of the blended out foundation. You can see it's got a good, nice, even coverage. And these bristles are so densely packed that it gives a very flawless finish. Usually brushes are very tough to use if you are a newcomer to makeup. If you have never used makeup brushes before, it could leave streaks, but this particular brush will never do that. So next in line, I have another brush, which is the Cuffs and Lashes F103 brush. This is a very nice brush. It's, you know, sort of angled like that, and it's very nice to apply foundation. Again, if you want a full coverage of foundation application, this is the perfect brush to use. I'm going to give you a closer look. You can see it's very densely packed. Again, it's got a nice angle to it, and this particular brush is very nice and soft to use. Okay, it's a very nice brush. See, I've taken the same concealer on my hand. I'm going to use the Cuffs and Lashes brushes and sort of buff the particular foundation out. So these bristles are very densely packed, and it's very soft, so it's not going to leave any streaks. So it's very good for newcomers. Again, just giving you a closer look. Just have a look how well the foundation is blended out. That's exactly what you want. But one drawback with this brush is that it's too big, you know, to sort of take under your eyes. So you will need a separate concealer brush for this. But the foundation blends out beautifully with this particular brush. So next up, I have the stippling brush, and this particular brush is from MAC. It's the Gigi Hadid collection, which I purchased about I think 10-15 years back. I'm first going to explain what a stippling brush is, okay? Just have a closer look at this brush. You know that this particular portion of this brush is very densely packed. It's circular, okay? At the same time, the top portion is very, very loosely packed. And it's very soft, okay? So I'm just putting slight pressure and you can see how this is sort of bending and how this brush sort of moves around. So this particular brush is perfect for airbrush kind of a finish, okay? Whether you're applying your compact, whether you're applying your foundation, the way this applies your foundation is very, very thin, very, very flawless and very, very beautiful. The layer of foundation will not be thick. You cannot achieve a full coverage with a stippling brush. Now I'm going to show you the demo of it. So the same drill, I have the concealer on my hand. I'm just going to go with the stippling brush. And always when you stipple, you go in circular soft motions. I'll just show you how soft my application is. I'm not at all putting pressure, but you can see how this brush is just swirling the product around and applying a thin layer. So it'll not let the product to, you know, apply in a very thick manner. It's a very, very beautiful brush. You can either go in strokes like this, but the circular motion is the best, okay? How beautiful this foundation application has turned out because of the stippling brush. It's completely dewy and completely sheer coverage. For people who like sheer coverage, who don't want a very thick base application or something which is too cakey, this is the perfect brush for you. Even if you're a beginner, you can purchase this stippling brush. You get it in pack, you get it in so many other companies. You can purchase a good stippling brush, and even if you're a beginner, purchase this brush and sort of stipple around the product if it's an everyday use as well. This is perfect for that. And then I have this particular brush, which is the PAC 307. Many people really don't like the flat foundation brush because many of them don't know how to use it. Many of you will place it on your face and swipe the product around. That's not how this brush works. Just take a closer look of this brush. You'll see that the bristles are long, it's thin, and it's very beautiful and soft for foundation blending. But many people who, you know, sort of swipe this brush around on their face get a lot of lines. So they say that this brush is not good at all to use for foundation. It's absolutely wrong. It's the perfect brush for foundation application and blending. It's an old school makeup artist brush and I really, really love it. I've applied the concealer again on my hand. The same drill, I'm going to pick up this brush, okay? This is the PAC 307, we were talking about that. And you need to place this brush at an angle like this of 90 degrees to the face and then go this way, okay? You just need to go fast in this way and blend, blend and blend away, okay? Can you see how beautifully this foundation is blending out? I am not using it in this way, just the tip of the brush, okay? This way and just do this, okay? That's all you need to do, slight pressure. You'll feel like your skin is getting a massage. That's the way you need to apply foundation. And look at this flawless full coverage application of the concealer. It's so, so, so good, guys. And this particular brush is all in one. You can use it with a cream product, liquid product, everything. It can go under your eyes, you can go above your eyes, you can go into the crevices. Like, see, this gap is very, very less for me, but this brush will perfectly fit there and I can put on the foundation without it getting on my hairline. That's the most beautiful part about this brush. Old is gold, guys. This is a very, very good brush. If you are a professional makeup artist, invest in one like this. Practice with it. You will notice that the foundation application is so, so, so flawless with this particular brush. So I have another hero, the Real Techniques brush in the number 204. I love, love, love this particular brush. I'm going to give you a closer look. These are synthetic fibers, okay? It's got a nice dome shape and it's not very, very densely packed, okay? It's pretty dense, but not very densely packed. And it's got this dome shape on top, okay? If you compare it with any other brush that I just showed you, okay? Compared to that, this dome shape will be very, very clearly visible, the dome shape on this particular brush. It's a beautiful, beautiful brush, guys. Look at that. Okay, now I'm going to show you how it's going to blend the foundation. It's just so beautiful. You can achieve any look with this particular brush. And as usual, I have a layer of concealer. I'm going to take the Real Techniques brush and just buff, okay? this particular brush, you don't need to press too hard, just slightly, just buff it out. Look at the finish, guys. It's so good, so flawless. It doesn't leave any damn streak. It's such a beautiful brush. So one drawback with respect to Real Techniques brushes is that every particular brush has its own function. So you cannot multitask a brush too much because it's specifically made for that particular usage. This is a buffing brush. You can use it to buff out your foundation. You can use it to buff out your powder foundation. You can use it for powder application on the face or blush. All those things can be done. So basically base application, you can do it with this particular brush. But if you want to apply concealer or something where you need to go into the little nooks and crannies of your face, this brush will not work for you. You will have to use another brush when it comes to concealer application. So that's what I have noticed with Real Techniques brushes, but otherwise this brush is so good and totally worth investing on. So the last product that I want to show you in this series is the makeup sponge. Okay, makeup sponge can be of various types. You know, it can be dewdrop shaped like this, it could be flat on top, or it could be diamond shaped. There are so many beauty blenders in various shapes and sizes that you get, but it's a very good tool, especially for beginners. If you are a beginner, ditch the brush. Pick a beauty blender or a makeup sponge, okay? It's very good. So this particular sponge can be used in two different ways. One, you can use it damp, or another way that you can use it is you can use it dry as it is. So if you are from the oily skin type, okay, you have a lot of oil secretion and your makeup doesn't sit on your skin properly. Many of them on Instagram have asked me that as well. How do I put makeup on my skin? It's so oily. This is the product for you to use. If your beauty blender is dry and you put foundation on your face and buff it out with this particular product, it will remove all the oils and moisture on your skin. So use the beauty blender dry if you have oily skin. Same way, if you have dry skin, use the beauty blender after it's damp. Wet the beauty blender, squeeze out the water completely. There should be no water when you squeeze it out. However hard you squeeze it out, there should be no water. That means that the beauty blender is ready to use. If you squeeze and even one drop of water comes, go to the sink, again squeeze it out completely, and that's how you use a beauty blender, okay? It's very good. I'm going to show you the beauty blender application dry today, but you can use it damp or you can use it dry. And again, I have the concealer on my hand, okay? There are two points to a beauty blender. One will be pointed like this, other one will be big. In some way or the other, this particular phenomena will always come. So you need to bounce the beauty blender on your face. Never swipe it that way. Just bounce, okay? I'll just show you how flawless this finish is. And when you are a newcomer, using a beauty blender is very good, because if you apply too much product in a way that it's going to turn cakey and you don't know how much of product would turn your makeup cakey, this is the thing to go for. A beauty blender will suck out the excess product from your face. But if you're a makeup artist who wants to save makeup, don't get this, just use a brush, okay? So yes, those were the tools that I wanted to show you with respect to foundation application. From my huge collection of brushes and beauty tools, these brushes and this particular beauty blender has really worked a lot for me. I really love these particular brushes. It has worked wonders when it comes to foundation application, and I can really trust it whenever I go for bridal makeup as well. I don't take risk with respect to the brushes that I carry. So before buying something, I have to tell you a few things so that you can make a clear decision as to this is what I want, this is what I don't want. You will get a clear picture of everything and you can pick the right product. When it comes to foundation application, the brush bristles do not suck in product, okay? They're going to just swirl the product around. Maybe a little bit of the product will stick to the bristles, like how it has happened now. But you can see that it never sucks in any product. Like if I go on and applying now, this particular brush is completely going to put all the product on my hand. Maybe slightly it'll get stained, okay? That's all will happen with brushes. But when it comes to a beauty blender, the product sucks in a lot of product. Like I was mentioning, if you have applied way too much product, the beauty blender will take out the excess product from your skin to give a very flawless, smooth base. That's very important. So whenever you're picking up a brush, keep in mind that the brush product wastage will not be there, but at the same time, lot of practice is required to use brushes. And on the other hand, for ease of use and for a beautiful, sheer, lovely coverage, pick a beauty blender. So now I think you got a clearer picture of what you want to buy and how you want to use these tools and products. You can pick the right products based on your requirements so that you don't waste money, never buy kits. So watch this series, you're going to get to know about each kind of brush for each usage on your particular skin type. So it's really going to help you. Watch the complete sessions, okay? I will see you all in another video and I hope this video was helpful. Before signing off, don't forget to hit the subscribe button right there and hit the notification bell so that you'll be notified whenever I post a video. Take care, okay? Loads of love to all of you. Bye-bye.